Okay, thank you very much. Let me talk about the status of insecticide resistance in arboviruses vectors in Eastern Mediterranean region. I am the professor of medical entomology and vector control, School of Public Health, Tehran University. In addition, this much good pleasure to have collaboration with WHO as a member of vector control advisory group, and we are good collaboration with Dr. Rahman and their friends. WHO announced in 2014 this small bite and big threat. Now we have a lot of problem in the world. If we consider the regions, these regions is 23 countries, is WHO Eastern Mediterranean region, nearly all of the countries has got the problem. So there is no good registry in terms of, you know, diseases, epidemic, other things. And vector-borne disease in the region is Zika, dengue, chikungunya, yellow fever, sand fly fever, Rift Valley, West Nile, different encephalitis, Kirimengungo, tick-borne. And in addition, we have got malaria, plague, lymphatic filariasis, leishmaniasis, and onchocerciasis. So distribution of vector-borne disease in EMRO, this is the last one. This is schisto, African, onchocerciasis, lymphatic, Japanese, dengue, and other things that I got from the EMRO. And malaria in EMRO is the more problematic disease, you can see. And in 15 million cases in EMRO, WHO provided a scholarship and paid the money for participation of the, you know, participants from different parts of the world, and we conducted international courses on malaria. Why I'm talking about malaria? There are some reports now. The malaria vector are actually could be vector of the Zika. Yeah, there is some reports. There's Anopheles maculopinus. They found the positive to Zika. So this capacity building, this friends coming from different parts of the world. I am the manager of the course and conducting the course from different parts. And those, all of them, about 300 graduate from this course. Some of them is here. And they work on arbovirus as well. So 300 participants so far and granted by WHO. And this is an addition. There are cutaneous leishmaniasis in 2000. You can see everywhere. This is visceral leishmaniasis everywhere. And this is the anthropometric visceral leishmaniasis. You can see everywhere. You will see different diseases. This leishmaniasis, everybody knows about that. Why I'm talking leishmaniasis? Because we have got sand fly fever. Sand fly fever is arboviruses. So at the same time, we have got leishmania. In addition, we have got sand fly fever. These arboviruses. This is the reservoir of the VL, and VL in different part of the world, as well as in. This sand fly female transmit diseases, this cutaneous leishmaniasis. Everywhere we have cutaneous leishmaniasis, we have got sand fly fever as well. This is the reservoir, the rhomboides opimus, and this is the Phelps papatosi, the vectors, and we are rearing this species in my country. And this is symptoms of the leishmania. You can see a lot of people suffering from the leishmania. This is the scar of the leishmania, and this is the local leishmania. And just show the importance of disease. And the reservoir of the visceral leishmaniasis as well as anthropometric leishmaniasis. And you can see it is infected with visceral leishmaniasis. And this is the visceral leishmaniasis inside the body. Normally in my country, we are working on distribution of all of the vectors, and we mapped all of the vectors. For example, they are vectors of the Kandeliki, Alexandria, the vectors, all of the visceral leishmaniasis in the country, and we are working on it. In addition, we are conducting international course on leishmania. Because of the sand fly fever and the leishmania is more problem in the region, and a lot of people graduate from the course, and I'm conducting these international courses in hyper-endemic area of the country. We have in the region there is lymphatic filariasis. Why? Because the vectors is the culex, the same vectors. This is the lymphatic filariasis. You can see in Sudan everywhere. And this is the symptom of lymphatic filariasis and the culex confusion. You can see culex everywhere. Everywhere, they are the vectors of Rift Valley fever, West Nile virus, and other arboviruses. And it's the river blindness. They have got a problem in their country, in endemic countries. You can see Sudan, Yemen, and this schistosomiasis also in the EMRO region. This dengue outbreak in the region, you can see in Pakistan, Saudi Arabia, Yemen, Sudan, and different parts of the country. We had the outbreak in Iran. We have got outbreak as well sometimes. And the dengue in the world, in the EMRO region, is the in Egypt, Somalia, Sudan, Djibouti, and Pakistan. This is the actual serotype of the dengue reported from different parts of the region. And then there is Egyptian albopictus and other species could transmit the diseases. In the neighboring, we are working in collaboration with Pakistan. They reported dengue, chikungunya, West Nile. In Saudi Arabia, dengue, Rift Valley fever. In Iraq, West Nile. And this introduced through the lucky bamboo. It's coming from different parts of the world. And we have got this. We collected the eggs from the lucky bamboos. Chikungunya, 2011, reported from the Yemen, Al-Hudaydah. Now there is a lot of conflict there. And this is distribution chikungunya, you can see in the region. And yellow fever also affected in the EMRO region. This is symptoms of yellow fever, everybody knows. The yellow fever outbreak since 2000, this is the EMRO region, you can see. And distribution of Zika viruses. You can see in the borderline, Afghanistan, Pakistan, India, and some part of the EMRO region. These symptoms of Zika, my colleague mentioned about that. And this Zika virus vectors, albopictus and aegypti. In addition, there are some reports that others could transmit the Zika viruses. And distribution of the actually dengue risk. How to study, the method of study, when I was researching about insecticide resistance, there are different methods, susceptibility test, using the WHO guideline, irritability test for adults, and collected the larvae and rare in the insectary. And after that, they did susceptibility test. They collected mosquito at different methods, for example, for animal bed, human bed, indoor collection for light traps and different methods, and they used different concentration of insecticide recommended by WHO, DDT 4% on cyphertrin and so on. This is a diagnostic dose actually for evaluation of subset. This is the criteria for susceptible, resistance, and mortality. This criteria has been changed. Recently, this is the new one. The concentration and exposure time change. So result is not comparable. For some 3 years ago, somebody do some resistance, but this year, if somebody do this year, is not comparable because the criteria completely changed. This is the first time in Pakistan they did Aedes albopictus, and I measured the LC50 value for Aedes albopictus in Pakistan. They used different insecticide, and they measured LC50. You can see the LC50 at different part of the country. This albopictus in Pakistan, you can see different insecticide, larvicide with LCV, and different, actually, regions, Lahore, and different region of the Pakistan. This is Pakistan as well, LC50 in 2010. You can see different insecticide, and this is the LC50 at different regions. This is Egypt in Somalia. The only report that we have got from Somali, these Aedes aegypti, you can see to diazinone, the LC50 is so high. The another thing is in Mecca in Saudi Arabia, only we have got one, this one, deltamethrin lambda sulfletrin, insecticide resistance in Aedes albopictus in Saudi Arabia. You can see all of them are resistant to different insecticides. This is the larvicide actinic icon. You can see the LC50 value in Saudi Arabia and the Culex. Culex pepins complex, it has got problem West Nile sandwich, and recently the Zika virus also reported from the Culex. And different, you know, arboviruses. This West Nile, you can see everywhere, even in EMRO regions, in Rift Valley fever, distribution map you can see in Rift Valley fever, a lot of in Somalia and Djibouti. And vectors of Rift Valley fever is Culex trichorhinchus and Aedes vexans. Another Aedes could transmit the Rift Valley fever vector. This is Rift Valley outbreak in Saudi Arabia, Egypt, Sudan, everywhere. You can see. And this Rift Valley outbreak 2016, you can see everywhere we have got outbreak of Rift Valley fever. This virus, and recently from Iraq. The problem that with Culex, there are a lot of sibling species. Pipins, Culex, Concavasiatus, Molestus, Palens, and so every day they produce new species. And it's very difficult, actually, to distinguish. In Iran, we did susceptibility of the Culex, Concavasiatus to different insecticides. And this is the LT50, you can see very high. We exposed about 4 days of Culex pepinus to DDT, but no mortality. Very strong resistance. Can you see the LT50 and this deltometry? Very resistant to, and the reason a lot of agricultural pests and home pesticides are being used for in the region. Another problem that we have got in the region is CCHF, Crimean Congo hemorrhagic fever. One of the problem in Iran as well, we have got the problem with CCHF and in EMRO, and this is the symptom of CCHF. And you can see the reservoir, we have got different type of reservoirs and tick transmit the disease, hard ticks and soft ticks. We are rearing both vectors in country. They have vectors, Ornithidurus, Argazide, and all of them, the vectors of CC, we find all of them positive. This is vectors as well. And we mapped, actually, the prevalence of diseases in the country according to the region. You can see we have got problems in some parts. And the tick resistance. We evaluated the resistance for those are, this is Ornithus lahurensis and Argos reflex. We evaluated against different insecticides, and we evaluated the LT50. And this is the regression line to different ticks. These ticks, this is the another ticks, Rhizopholis bursa, this LC50, and we have got the sandfly fever. You can see in this part, in the region, we have got sandfly fever. Iran also, we have got sandfly fever. And this sandfly fever, this bunyavri, the same vectors of Leishmania and the same reservoir of the Leishmania are the sandfly vectors. We understand the actually distribution of papatosi and sergenti, the vectors of diseases. This map, this me, I collected sandfly and I reared in the insectary. We have got insectary for sandfly. It's very difficult to rear. And then this is the evaluated susceptibility test for sandfly and evaluated the LT50 with DDT, permethrin, deltamethrin, sulfletrin, lambda sulfletrin, and then different insecticide, male and female. This is the LT50 comparing DDT and other things, male and female of papatosi, and this is LT50 and other things. The only things that have done in Morocco is Phyllopsis sergenti. Just they found DDT, the lambda cell, and malathion 100% mortality in these insecticides. And a lot of problem. We have got to be insect resistant in the world, and we have no choice. What is the best thing is collaboration between animal health, plant protection units, and public health sectors to overcome the pesticide resistance. And thank you very much for your kind attention. Thank you.